Sly Stewart, who would go on to be known as Sly Stone, with Walking in Jesus' Name in 1952. He was just 9 years old. I'm joined by John Morrison today on World Cafe for the Culture Corner. We're talking about Sly and the Family Stone's album, There's a Riot Going On, which turns 50 this year. So Sly Stone, you know, grew up in the Church of God in Christ, but there's another place that had an impact on Sly right around the time, or I guess a little bit before he would have been working on this album. Very different from church. Could you tell us where he was living and working?
Yeah, absolutely. Sly actually was living as a young man. He lived in San Francisco, and he was there at the height of the hippie psychedelic movement. You know, he was actually 24 years old in 1967 when the Summer of Love popped off. And Sly was actually active in that music scene and really in a bunch of music scenes in San Francisco at the time. He was working as a popular radio DJ. He also produced records as a young person for local rock bands like the Bo Brummels. He worked with Grace Slick's first band, The Great Society. So he was really doing all of this stuff on the rock end, but also was still very much involved in the R&B and like black music, soul music side of the music scene in San Francisco and Oakland. So he was really absorbing all of these different influences, rock, you know, the blues, soul music, and kind of synthesizing it into his musical vocabulary.
Right, and his time there, you know, would have overlapped with the civil rights movement, which sort of came to a close in 1968. So I would imagine there was a lot of change happening in, you know, R&B and in black music and in politics around that time.
Yeah, absolutely. By the time this album came out, There's a Riot Going On in 1971, you know, that was the year Marvin Gaye put out What's Going On. You know, Philly International was formed in 1971. You had artists like Curtis Mayfield and Aretha Franklin embracing a more like overtly political and socially informed music, but also reaching their creative primes. And this album was a standout of all of that. It came right in like the sweet spot of this renaissance of black music.
The next song that we're going to hear references Haight-Ashbury. It's called Love and Hate, spelled H-A-I-G-H-T. Why did you want to play this song for us?
This song is the album's opener. And when I listened to this, I imagine that this song, Love and Hate, had to be striking for folks who were familiar with Sly and the Family Stone and their prior music. And, you know, hearing this for the first time, it had to be, you know, kind of like, you know, a shock a little bit to experience this. Love and Hate is loose. It's like almost chaotic sounding. It's a very strange sounding song. It doesn't sound like anything else, you know, quite like anything else that came out at the time. And, you know, the lyrics are impressionistic. You don't immediately know if Sly is describing like a drug high or if he's talking about being caught up in some other kind of feeling. And it really has just like a darkness and a heaviness that will be carried throughout the rest of the album.
Let's hear it. This is Love and Hate, Sly and the Family Stone on World Cafe.
Let's
talking about that album today on the Culture Corner with John Morrison on World Cafe. At the beginning of our conversation, we talked a bit about the influences that made Sly and the Family Stone who they were as a band. Sly growing up in church, we talked about Haight Ashbury, everything that's kind of going on at the time. How did they apply the influences that they were taking with them into There's a Riot Going On?
Yeah, it's interesting because everything that Sly and the Family Stone did, they did like slightly skewed, right? So Love and Hate very much takes like the vocal sound of Black American gospel, but it approaches it in like this loose, kind of like chaotic way, right? There's a song on this album called Brave and Strong. You know, it's funky and it is funk, but it's like a weird minimalist funk. You know, Sly was also someone who was very much interested in experimenting with music technology, and like he was always kind of like on the cutting edge of music technology. This is one of the first big pop albums that employed a drum machine to use for the rhythm tracks. So he's pulling from all of this stuff. You hear the blues, you hear gospel, you hear psychedelic rock. They mix all of this stuff up, but they do it in like a slightly left field way.
And so what are we hearing in the song Just Like a Baby, which is the next one we're gonna play?
Yeah, Just Like a Baby might be my favorite song from this album. When I first heard this album years ago, this was the one that stood out and grabbed me. But it's the blues, but like I said, it's like a left field blues. And musically, the song is like very stripped down, and it's almost like painfully bare and stripped down. And the vocal is firmly in like the blues tradition, but it's just kind of like a weird, messed up blues. The writer Miles Marshall Lewis wrote an incredible 33 and a third book about There's a Riot Going On, and at one point he describes Just Like a Baby as dangerously beautiful in its despair. And it really is like a remarkable, like, agonizing song.
Blind Family Stone, Just Like a Baby.
Just like a baby.
Morrison for the Culture Corner. We're talking about Sly and the Family Stone's album. There's a riot going on, which turns 50 this year. So what is the legacy of this album? Who has it influenced? What's its impact?
It's had a lot of impact, a lot of influences. Sly not only influenced his contemporaries, like Miles Davis was famously inspired by Sly and the Family Stone to set off, you know, the fusion movement, where Miles would, in jazz, where Miles would experiment with electronic instruments and effects and all of that stuff and create this kind of new wave in music. That came from him, you know, hearing and seeing Sly and the Family Stone. So not only did Sly make waves, you know, in the early 70s, he also influenced Prince, you know, D'Angelo, Janelle Monáe, Janet Jackson, you know, all kind of folks. Anywhere where R&B meets electronic music or rock, you know, all these eclectic fusions of music that we kind of take for granted now, you know, Sly set a lot of that stuff off and set a precedent for a lot of it.
I wonder if there's a clip of a song that we could play from an artist who's really been notably impacted where you can really hear it.
Yeah, absolutely. Childish Gambino's 2016 album, Awaken My Love, is a gorgeous psychedelic soul record that is highly influenced not only by Parliament Funkadelic, but also Sly and the Family Stone. There's a song on Awaken My Love called Baby Boy that sounds a lot like Sly and the Family Stone's Just Like a Baby. It's almost an homage to that song.
Let's hear a little bit of that right now.
Allegory, you know, kind of playing in his mind as he's writing this song. So it's a very unique, very strange song to be a hit and for it to be this band's final hit of their career.
Yeah. Lots to listen for here. It might make you think about it a little bit differently. This is Family Fair from Sly and the Family Stone.
One child grows up to be some part of it just loves to learn, and another child grows up to be somebody you just love to burn. Mom loves to pull the veil, you see it's in her blood. Both kids are good.
Family Affair from their album There's a Riot Going On turns 50 this year. Been talking about it with John Morrison today on the Culture Corner. John, I feel like every time I talk to you, I come away loving music even more than I did when we started. So thank you so much.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
John Morrison is a podcast host and host of Culture Cycle Radio on WXPN in Philadelphia, where we make World Cafe. He joins me every month for the Culture Corner. I'm Marina Duras, back in a moment with more World Cafe.
Member-supported public radio, the independent 88.5 FM and 88.5FM.org.
Hey, this is Nick Harmcourt inviting you to join me at the other end of the day on the Monday nights at 9 when I bring you the 9 o'clock news. 30 minutes of brand new, upcoming, and recent releases from across the musical spectrum. Please join me Monday nights at 9 for the 9 o'clock news here at 88.5 FM.
Hello, this is Kevin Bronson, host of the weekly LA Buzz Band Show, your home for local music on the independent 88.5 FM. I'd like to invite you to join me on a new night. So join me every Thursday at 9 o'clock for the LA Buzz Band Show on the station where local music lives and thrives. Listener-supported 88.5 FM.
Wake up with a smarter morning show. Nick Harcourt every weekday from 6 to 11 on the independent 88.5 FM.
Hey, welcome back to the World Cafe. That's at World Cafe on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. If you're on social media, you can find us. We can be friends. I'm Marina Duras. New music from Alt-J and Casey Musgraves on the way in a bit. But first, to Desky Trucks Band. Anyhow.